Wooden coasters used to be the only thing that you can find at parks and fairs 65 years ago. The steel coaster wasn't even really a concept until Aerodynamics introduced the first steel tubular track with the Matterhorn in 1959. And suddenly, the wooden coaster had some competition. Aerodynamics and Schwarzkopf brought the steel coaster to prominence in the 60s and 70s, and that's become the material of choice for all parks and chains, with a few exceptions. Wooden coasters may be cheaper to manufacture up front, but they need constant maintenance to keep them running smooth, something a steel coaster doesn't have to worry about nearly as much. Wooden coasters went from the only thing to a novelty, something to bring back nostalgia and offer the guests a different ride experience from a park full of steel monsters. But there are still some parks out there with an actual wooden coaster collection. I define this as three or more, and today, I want to highlight them and see who has the best ones. These are the world's greatest wooden coaster collections. Before I get started with the 14 parks that qualify for this list, let me highlight a few parks with a pair of notable wooden coasters that fell short of the trio needed for this list. Worlds of Fun has Prowler and Timberwolf, one of the better GCIs and one of the better DIN coasters ever built, both still going strong. Kentucky Kingdom also boasts a really good DIN coaster in Thunder Run, and they just added a brand new family Woody, Kentucky Flyer, in 2019. Valley Fair also has a classic Woody in High Roller, along with one of the most well-regarded modern Woodies in Renegade. Waldemere has had Comet for 57 years to thrill younger coaster fans, and in 2008, they introduced Ravine Flyer 2, an absolute monster from the Gravity Group. Port Aventura opened their two wooden coasters on the same day, both by CCI, one a dual-tracked Woody called Stampeda, and the other a family-style Woody called Tomahawk. Finally, Silverwood has an iconic duo of Woodies with Timber Terror and Tremors, and for a long time, this was reason enough for coaster fans to make their way to Northern Idaho, but their latest additions have all been steel, so they're lacking that last Woody that they need to make the list. Number 14. Canada's Wonderland, with Mighty Canadian Mindbuster, Wild Beast, and Ghoster Coaster. This is a rough trio of Woodies, I'm not gonna lie, with Ghoster Coaster being for kids and families, and the others being originals of the park, going back to its opening year of 1981. Wild Beast has more of a compact plot, while Mindbuster is an out-and-back Woody. But from my experience in 2018, they were both very rough, and didn't have a lot of redeeming factors. I have a feeling that 40 years after they opened their gates, Canada's Wonderland and Cedar Fair may be looking at breaking up this trio and seeing if RMC can help out, or maybe they can use the plot of Wild Beast for something a lot better than what they have now. Number 13. Blackpool Pleasure Beach, with Big Dipper, Grand National, Nickelodeon Streak, and Blue Flyer. Here's an interesting quartet of old wooden coasters, and you know you're in for a good time when the youngest one in the bunch was built in 1935. Big Dipper is 98 years old, but it has respectable stats, with 3,300 feet of track and stands 60 feet tall. Nickelodeon Streak may be orange and have a modern theme, but it's 88 years old and has about 1,000 feet less of track than Big Dipper. Blue Flyer is a family wooden coaster with about 1,100 feet of track dating back to 1934. And finally, Grand National may be the youngster at 86 years old, but it has a bad reputation for being rough. Again, yet another wooden coaster around 60 feet tall. I've never been here, so it's hard to judge. But on paper, these Woodies are small to medium in size, and are, pretty old. Number 12. Adventureland, with Tornado, Outlaw, and the Underground. I haven't gotten to this park yet, though by the time this video is out, maybe I will. So I'm relying on the legend himself, Airtime Mike, to help me out here. Tornado is a William Cobb-designed wooden coaster going back to 1978, and apparently it's rough and boring. Not a good combo. On the other hand, Outlaw is a solid CCI dating back to the company's early years in 1993. A few good airtime hills with one ejector moment, and it seems to be the standout Woody in the park, since the Underground is more of a dark ride than a coaster, also from CCI, dating back to 1996. But it's good to have something different in the park, I guess. I don't know. I'm still looking forward to riding all of these in July. Number 11. Michigan's Adventure, with Shivering Timbers, Wolverine Wildcat, and Zack Sumer. When I was younger and just getting into coasters, Shivering Timbers was one of the biggest things out there. This massive CCI wooden coaster stands 122 feet tall and sports over a mile of track, going out and back with huge camelbacks and a very impressive structure. And 23 years later, it still stands as the park's standout coaster. The other Woodies are a different story. Zack Sumer is another CCI Woody, but this is a family version that came to the park in 1994 with 1,400 feet of track and a height of just 41 feet. Finally, Wolverine Wildcat has a bad reputation, and it's despised by a lot of enthusiasts. One of the DIN Corporation's few coasters remaining, and not a popular one at that. It's got respectable stats, standing 85 feet tall, and with 3,000 feet of track in its double out and back layout. But apparently it's rough, which is a theme with the Dinwiddies. Number 10, King's Dominion with Racer 75, Grizzly, and Woodstock Express. I had a hard time ranking this against Michigan's Adventure, with Shivering Timbers probably being the best Woody in either park, but Racer 75 and Grizzly standing in solid rides, with Woodstock Express being the family coaster, and those sounded like better options over the much-reviled Wolverine Wildcat, and then Zack Zoomer for the family crowd. While not spectacular, these Woodies are all good for a ride each time you go, Racer 75 being a park original, and one of those classic dual-track out-and-back Woodies, and Grizzly going out into the woods to provide a totally different ride experience. King's Dominion had so much wood in the park, they were able to sacrifice Hurler to create the world-class Twisted Timbers, a no-brainer move that was much needed for a park that hadn't gotten a new coaster in 8 years. Number 9. Hershey Park with Comet, Lightning Racer, and Wildcat. Comet really saves this Woody collection, the oldest of the bunch by a long shot, and offering the smoothest and most thrilling ride. Wildcat and Lightning Racer came 4 years apart in 1996 and 2000, both from GCI, and they're just not my favorite rides. What else can I say? Wildcat was GCI's first coaster, and the layout isn't good and it runs rough. And while Lightning Racer is a pretty smooth ride, it's just a boring ride to me. But I have to acknowledge that Lightning Racer has its fans, and I respect that. So I'll put this trio of Woodies in the middle of the pack. Number 8. Kennywood, with Thunderbolt, Jackrabbit, and Racer. In terms of a collection of classic Woodies, Kennywood is top of the class. All of these coasters trace their origins back to the 1920s, though Thunderbolt was totally overhauled and expanded in the 60s. These are smooth rides. Thunderbolt has some good drops and a long ride time over a perfect terrain layout. Jackrabbit also uses terrain to its advantage and has the famous double down, which is a good element, just a little overrated. And Racer runs smooth, but it's the weakest coaster of the three. Just like Lightning Racer, it has the racing aspect to show off, but otherwise it's a pretty dull ride experience. Still, it's impressive how Kennywood keeps these Woodies running great after all these years. Number 7. Six Flags St. Louis with American Thunder, The Boss, and Screamin' Eagle. This is such a polarizing collection. Nobody seems to agree on any of these. For me, American Thunder is great, The Boss was pretty trash, and Screamin' Eagle was average at best. But you'll find plenty of people who think that American Thunder is whatever, but love The Boss, and think that Screamin' Eagle is an airtime machine. I've only been to this park once, and I have two rides on American Thunder and The Boss, and just one on Screamin' Eagle, so maybe my opinion doesn't carry a lot of weight. I really need to get a second trip out there, which I hope to do at some point in 2021. No matter how you shake it, this park has three impressive large-scale wooden coasters, and they serve as the highlights of the park, since their steel coasters are either clones or they're terrible. Number 6. Indiana Beach with Cornball Express, Hoosier Hurricane, and Lost Coaster of Superstition Mountain. We're really moving into the elite territory now. Cornball Express is the park's best coaster, kind of running in a circular or square layout, and giving really good airtime over its peaks, something I really appreciated in the front. Hoosier Hurricane is a really enjoyable out-and-back Woody, but if I'm being honest here, it's hard to heap praise on Hoosier Hurricane, just because I expected it to be terrible, when it ended up being about the same type of ride experience as Lightning Racer. Hoosier Hurricane is still a gorgeous coaster to look at, and a fun one to grab a ride on. Then there's the ever so odd Lost Coaster, the weirdest coaster that I've ever been on, with two enclosed cars linked together, and with rows facing forward and backward. This ride seems to do so much while doing so little. With those tiny drops and sharp turns, it manages to be a thrilling experience, despite what your eyes tell you just by looking at the thing. All three of these were built by CCI, but all three managed to be so different. Number 5. Six Flags Great America with Goliath, Viper, American Eagle, and Little Dipper. Goliath is a standout here, one of the weakest RMCs, but an RMC nonetheless, and one of just two topper track Woodies in the country as of 2021. Its short ride time is packed with good inversions and airtime moments, and it's visually amazing. I have made it known that I'm a big Viper fan. The Coney Island Cyclone replica is the best that I've ever ridden, and that includes the Coney Island Cyclone itself. This is such a sleeper hit in the park. American Eagle was Intamin's first wooden coaster, as well as their first large-scale coaster period, celebrating its 40th anniversary in 2021, and its future has been in question for years now. Will it get new trains, the RMC treatment, or will it be scrapped entirely? It's a big racing wooden coaster, and even though it runs rough, especially in the Helix, it's a solid ride. Little Dipper was relocated from a nearby park that closed down, making its debut in 2010. Giving the park a much-needed kid-friendly coaster, but it's still not too small for adults to enjoy also. Number 4. Kings Island with The Beast, Mystic Timbers, Racer, and Woodstock Express. Some people may have this higher, but I couldn't do it. Racer is not only a park original, but it's the coaster that's given credit for reigniting the coaster industry in the early 70s. Today, it's a little outdated and it ran a little rough, but by all accounts, The work the park did over the offseason smoothed it out a lot. Woodstock Express is yet another one of these family woodies, and serves as kind of a bonus coaster here. But it's the other two that drive this ranking into the final four. The Beast was so significant for the park and the industry, as before then, the coaster revolution that Racer kicked off was mainly made up of cookie-cutter out-and-back racing coasters, or small-scale looping coasters, by the middle of the 1970s. The Beast was a whole new monster, with over 7,000 feet of track, and taking place entirely in the woods, with an epic helix finale, and the whole thing was built by the park itself. It's still a must-ride today more than 40 years later, but my favorite Woody there is Mystic Timbers, GCI's finest work of art in America, breaking away from their Twister model for this out-and-back layout that still manages to feel like it's out of control, all the while providing a glossy smooth ride and a bunch of airtime. Kings Island may be missing Son of Beast, but... wait a minute. No, they're not. That ride sucked. Sorry, airtime, Mike. Number 3. Mount Olympus, with Hades 360, Zeus, Cyclops, and Pegasus. Let's talk about Pegasus for 1 second. This ride blows. It's stupid, pointless, and awful, and the park needs to scrap it and get a Gravity Group family Woody in its place. Moving on. The other three Woodies are good to great. Zeus is an out-and-back airtime machine, featuring a great straight drop and airtime hills, before hitting that swooping turnaround, and heading back through more hills before it's over. It reminds me a lot of a coaster like Racer, just more modern and with better forces. Cyclops has a much stranger layout, built for the terrain, offering up some really good airtime in the beginning, before hitting that iconic drop. I ragged on this element a little bit because it wasn't the epic airtime moment that I was expecting, but you'll still fly out of your seat. Finally, there's Hades 360, and this turned out to be one of the best wooden coasters I've ever ridden. The Gravity Group slammed it out of the park on their first try, and that 2013 renovation to use Timberliners and include that inversion made it so much better. So much airtime, such a cool tunnel under the parking lot, such a long ride. If you can get past the roughness, you're in for an unforgettable ride experience, and it's the cherry on top of a great collection of Woodies. Minus Pegasus. Number 2. Knoebels, with Phoenix, Twister, and Flying Turns. I love Knoebels' collection because all these rides are completely different. Phoenix is a world-class airtime machine. Twister is all about speed and laterals. Flying Turns is a bobsled coaster. And the story behind all these rides is also interesting. Phoenix was relocated from a park in Texas in 1985. And here it is, winning the Golden Ticket Award for Best Wooden Coaster in the World. Twister was built totally in-house, rather than farming the task out to CCI or GCI. Flying Turns was also built by the park, and that process took 8 years for them to finally get right and get it open to the public. Knoebels has a lot of character, and these three standout coasters makes it a top-tier collection of Woodies. But there's just one other park that did it a little better. Number 1. Holiday World, with Voyage, Raven, and Legend. It'd be hard to argue with this one. Holiday World started working with CCI in the mid-90s, opening Raven as their first coaster in 1995, and all that did was win 3 golden tickets for the best wooden coaster. It may be a short ride, but it's an insane run through the woods, offering airtime and a relentless ride. Their big follow-up 5 years later was with the Legend, built less for airtime, but more for laterals, weaving under and around the slides in Splash and Safari. And even though this hasn't always been my favorite Woody, I got one spectacular ride in 2020, and that boosted my opinion of it by leaps and bounds. Finally, the Voyage was their magnum opus, built by the engineers from the now-defunct CCI, making up the Gravity Group. One of the most impressive wooden coasters ever built, for its size, length, and most of all, its use of terrain to successfully complete that whole course with a full head of steam, and doing it with just one lift hill. These three wooden coasters make up the top spot on this list, and it wasn't even a hard choice for me. That's a wrap on the best wooden coaster collections in the world. Let me know what you think about my rankings on this list, and where you would have slotted these parks if you disagree with anything that you see here. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to drop a like. That's the best way to show your support for the channel. And if you're new here and love coasters, be sure to sub and hit the bell for more content just like this. And also check out my links below for my Discord server, where you can chat with other fans of the channel, as well as my second channel, where I post copyright-free off-ride footage. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next time.